and tendencies that are seemingly hard to break are some of you in your world today. This was expected of some of you, as the world that you have emerged in after you stepped foot out of our door is a world filled with many of the temptations of a lower dimensional life. It is filled with many fruits of the tree of temptation, a tree that grows in many different places all throughout your lives and your planet. What we wish to do for you is to uproot, if you will, some of these trees to instead plant the flower garden where there used to be a tree of temptation. How best to approach this task, we have asked ourselves. We, the members of the Galactic Federation of Light and your ascended family, have battled these temptations before. This is why we feel we have the appropriate experience to assist you in this way and get to the root of this problem and eradicate these roots from your soil. Do you see why it is we that could possibly help you in this matter? Do you trust us and have faith in us that we have gone this road before? This is what we need from you. We need faith from you. We need trust from you, confidence and assurance that you now understand that we are, in relation to who you are, you. The only difference is we have already experienced what you are experiencing and many of you will experience in the days ahead. Again, we do not wish to offer the pretense that we've done it all and we know it all. No, not at all. We just wish for you to see and understand that we have some experience in these matters. We have some seasoned years behind us, you may say, and we do. We are many, and we have many years of experience behind us. We consciously remember all of our incarnations into the physical while you only remember this one, your current one, although all of the lessons that you have learned throughout all your previous incarnations are safely kept away in your subconscious memory banks. We do enjoy the advantage of consciously remembering these events and experiences, and we are able to dig into our filing cabinet of experiences, if you will, and pull out a complete report on what it is we experienced and how it is we were able to clear the obstacle. We would like to see more of you demonstrate for us your faith in us, your confidence in us, for we see this faith and confidence as very shaky at best in many cases, and we wish to remind you that you trusted us completely before you stepped out that door and into your mission. You then had absolutely no trouble at all putting all of your confidence and faith in us, in our organization and our abilities as a team and as individual guides as well. What has changed for you? If you now understand and believe who it is we are, we ask you why it is that this confidence hasn't followed. In other words, if you now understand that we are you and that we have experienced everything that you have and will experience and that we enjoy this advantageous point of view of everything that is transpiring in your world and, for some of you, in your lives, then we ask you why is it that you have trouble trusting us when it comes to decision time or when we offer you advice or we share insights into what is transpiring in your world. More say to you we have certain projects scheduled that still so many of you believe is a lie, is a pipe dream, as you call them. We look forward to the day when the vows we have made and the pictures we have painted for you of your future come alive for you right before your very eyes, and they will. You can mark our words on this. But this does not help you today, does it, dear ones? And it is today that many of you face a struggle and you need our assistance, and here we are in offers of our assistance. So what is it that is holding you up? Why is it that you are finding it difficult to trust us completely today? Is it because that we have told you that there are beings among us who may appear what you would envision as reptilian-like? Or there are beings here that resemble the great extraterrestrials that many of you have read about? We say to you we feel that our descriptions of some of the beings that are members of our organization has stirred the pot a bit of your light worker community and has caused a bit of an uproar, we will even say, and many of you have jumped ship, joining the mutiny of our communications to you through our channel. We say to you that you can have faith in us, that we clearly foresaw that our message would have this effect. You cannot really think that we did not clearly see that there would be many of you very upset and up in arms, as you say, because we have what you consider reptilian and great beings among us. Of course we saw this coming, dear ones. Don't you see that? Don't you see we purposely introduced what you would see as a reptilian and a great first? Do you think that was some sort of coincidence or an oversight on our part? Of course we did this on purpose. We were testing you? Yes. You see this now, don't you? We also introduced to you Greg's higher self, who is not a reptilian or a great, as it were. What he is an Arcturian. Yes. That is what Greg is. He is an Arcturian being from a galaxy very far from your Milky Way galaxy. He is from a galaxy known as the Taurid galaxy that is located in an area of this universe that is so remote that the beings there are a bit different than you and I. Yes. You and I are very similar, for I am a human-looking being just like you, and when I say human-looking instead of human, it is simply because my physical vessel was not born to Earth parents, but this does not mean my physical vessel differs from yours in any way whatsoever. This is very important for you to understand, that we cannot use the word human, for we are not purely human. For only those of you that were born to two human parents on your planet can be considered human. We feel many of you would understand this, and we feel you would understand why we must use terms like human-like or humanoid, each meaning the exact same thing. So here I am, a human-like or humanoid being. Yes, I have skin the color of what you would call your Caucasian race or white race. Yes, I am white, as you say. I have light brown or even blondish hair. I have blue eyes. I have very light skin, for we do not have a sun as you do, as we are primarily on board our ships in space, although we do visit planets that have suns naturally quite often, but still I do not spend much time in the sun, so my skin is not tan at all, and it certainly is not damaged in any way by the harmful effects of many suns throughout this universe. I take great care of my physical vessel, and we do enjoy the benefits of very advanced technologies to keep our vessels in perfect tune and conditioned over many long years. So there you have it. You have someone that looks exactly like you. I am a Pleiadian. I am from the world that orbits a star in the Pleiades star system. Yes, I am one of those who you may more easily identify with as your friends, as your ally, as someone that is just like you. Because to you this is due to the fact that I look like you. Do you see how kind of, and I do not wish to insult anyone or demean anyone, but you see how kind of silly this is, how kind of childish this is, how best to say, unworldly this is, that there are many of you breathing a sigh of relief right now because you found that one of us looks just like you. We see that as a bit silly, for as we said, it is not what we look like. It is what is inside. Do you think our channel Greg is so much different than you? You read our words that are shared through him each day, and you chat with him through your comments section and through messaging on Facebook each and every day. Many of you can consider yourself friends with him, for he is very outgoing, charming, sometimes we will say, very friendly, and always willing to joke it up. He would not hurt a fly, and as we described yesterday, you can understand that quite literally, as he literally chases flies around the house with all kinds of contraptions to lasso them up and safely relocate them outside, because he refuses to swap them, for he has a super big heart just as many of you do. You are just like him. He is one of you. He looks exactly like you, for he is right now a human being born to human parents in the state of New York in your United States in your Western Hemisphere. So he is just like you. He is your brother, and you are not afraid of him, are you? You do not distrust him, do you? Well, most of you anyway, for he has a following and a reputation as being a channel that cannot be trusted by a certain number of your light worker community. This is going to change, and it is going to change in a big way. And Greg is going to be seen as a pioneer, if you will, as the groundbreaker of a great deal of information that has not been shared to you through the means of any other channel. This is the surprise we have for you, and we have carefully manicured this surprise. We have sculpted it, for there is going to be a large lesson in this for many of you. Many of you who have distrusted him and attacked him and ridiculed him and hung him out to dry, as you say, and yes, even persecuted him, for many of you have done this and continue to do so today, and you will beneath this message today in many areas. Around your internet, you will persecute him. You will burn him at the stake for what he is doing and saying, which is truth. Everything that we have spoken through our channel Greg is truth. There are no two ways about this. Even if another channel or source that claims to be some kind of researcher, whatever that means, refutes what he says, how could anyone research what is going on in the fifth dimension without the use of a channel, we ask you? How is this possible? How can anyone on your planet know for an absolute fact and certainty what is transpiring beyond your third dimensional boundaries without a channel issuing them this information from us or one of the other galactic commands? We would like to see a number of you field this question today. How is it that any of you can claim to know anything about the higher stretches of this universe beyond the limits of your third dimension unless you are quoting and relying on the work of a channel? The channels in your world today are your eyes and your ears to the ground, as you say, and the ground is this, the higher dimensions of your universe. This is where we are, and we have but one means to communicate with you and share to you information and descriptions of our world. Everything that you understand about our dimensions beyond your third you have learned from our descriptions through our channels. If there is any other way that you think you have gained insight or any kind of information about our dimensions through any other source besides the channel of our communications, we wish to hear this right now, for there is absolutely no source of this information. There are no books in any of your libraries or bookstores that we have written. Yes, this is true. We have not published any books in your world. All of the books that speak about our dimensions and our organizations and your higher dimensional guides and angels is information that is either completely made up and fictional, or based on rumor and innuendo, or based on other people's descriptions. And we say these other people's descriptions are channels of this information that we have chosen to share with you. That's all there is. There is no other source of this information. There aren't any of you that have conscious memory of your lives and your existence beyond the limited realm of your third dimension. If there are any of you who believe that you have conscious memory of anything besides your current lifetime, we say to you that is an absolute impossibility, for you see, you could not access any of these memories, for they are not with you right now. They are not a part of your consciousness. They are tucked away safely someplace and they are protected. And these memories will be returned to you at the proper time, which is not now, and it was not at any time throughout your entire current lifespan. Now that we have that little matter cleared up, we say again to you, could any of you tell us where you possess any information about our organizations or about any of the higher dimensions of your universe that you have not received from a channel or someone else that is merely repeating the work of a channel or quoting a channel? Okay. So that is your assignment today, because we are very eager to learn this. Why some of you believe that you know for certain what life is like beyond these borders of your third dimension. Now that you have your assignment, let us continue with our discussion today, which primarily focuses on why there are those of you who judge another upon the outer layers of their skin and their vessels that they have, in many cases, chosen to experience their creator-given lives and creator-built universe. We say to you, there are many of us, and we believe that most of you understand this. We introduced you to three types of beings in our last message, though many of you don't seem to remember that very clearly or accurately. You seem to believe we only introduced two types of beings to you. We see this as more disinformation, either purposely or accidentally, but we do see this as disinformation, and we wish more of you that are going to spread this kind of disinformation to please read our messages more carefully. We clearly introduced you to three types of beings, not two. We introduced you to a being that may resemble to you a reptilian, one that resembles what you describe and know as a tall great, and we introduced you to a light blue-skinned, white-haired 6½-foot tall being with big loving eyes. And we explained to you that this was Greg's higher, or what you may know as future self. He is an Arcturian being, and Arcturian beings are gentle, they are kind, they are vastly intelligent, They have superior technologies over many civilizations throughout this universe. Yes. They have been around for millions and millions of years. This is why their technology is so superior to many other races, worlds and alliances alike. They have massive ships that can travel this universe all around in seconds. They can pop in out of realities that will boom, 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 boom. One dimension to the next, higher and higher. They have no limits of the dimensions that they can travel to. Do you understand what this means? Do you understand what we are explaining to you here, that Greg's higher self is not a being limited to the fifth dimension? Greg's higher self is a being that has achieved the peak of this universe, which at this time is your 12th dimension. Greg's higher self is a 12th dimensional being, and this means so is Greg, for Greg is the vehicle, the eyes and the ears of his higher self in a third dimensional world. But this does not mean that Greg cannot also travel through the dimensions on and up to the 12th, for he can and he will in the days ahead, and he already completely understands this. He has figured this out a long time ago. This is why he describes his star family as an 11th dimensional collective, for he knew this, for this information was shared with him a long time ago, and he knew that he, through his work here and his sincere efforts, would be graduating, if you will, one day from the 11th dimension to the 12th. He knew this. He has talked about this with his brother and his friends, although most of his friends are like many of you and don't believe much of what he is saying, and this is a real shame, for Greg has friends that are right here with him in this, your third dimensional world, who are also 11th dimensional beings who have now, through their work here and their experiences here, graduated to the peak, the plateau of the 12th dimension. What do you think about that? Do you think this is another light being propagated by Greg or by us through Greg? We politely say to you, we have had enough of those of you accusing us of lights, and we are going to silence many of Greg's and our critics in the very near days ahead. And although we have no vendettas or scores, if you will, personal or otherwise, we are really looking forward to this day. For it is going to calm the seas of this slanted rhetoric and accusation and name-calling and challenges and threats of all kinds, physical or legal and other types of threats that Greg has received. Yes, there are those of you who are threatening Greg with physical violence. Can you believe that? And there are those of you who have threatened him with legal action to silence him. We tell you that you really don't know Greg if you think threats of violence or legal action will intimidate him, that he has seen it and done it all. This is why he is now a 12th dimensional being, for you see, he has just experienced what many of you will now begin to experience, or you have experienced, for that's what it's all about. There are simply those of you, and Greg is one of you, who have gone on before you. Do you see this now? We all do and experience the same things, just at different times. That's how we can assist you on your journey, and that's why we say to you, put your trust and faith in us, for there are things that many of you are experiencing right now today, and you will experience in the days to come, that we literally have lived through ourselves, sometimes more than once, as sometimes we required more than one experience or one lesson of a particular subject matter to learn from. This is true for all of you, and this is true for Greg too. For sometimes he has had to learn a hard lesson, the same hard lesson more than once. You can ask him and he'll tell you. He has had trouble with the law. He has had trouble with violence, fighting gang members in the street, yes. Did you know that Greg grew up in a gang? We bet many of you would be quite surprised to learn this. Greg grew up in a gang that could be rather violent at times, and Greg learned how to fight and survive on the street, for this is what he felt was a needed lesson for him in this lifetime. He felt that he could take what he learned here and apply it to his higher selves, to his career with the Ashtar Command. Yes, Greg is a commander in the Ashtar Galactic Command. That is who he is. That is his career. And he felt he could learn so much from growing up in tough neighborhoods and battling it out with gang members on the street, and we tell you we are not describing for you events that have happened in Greg's very distant past in this lifetime. Either. No. Just a couple of years ago he was still in front of his house in the middle of the street fighting more than one gang member at a time. That's right. That's what Greg is. He is tough as nails and he doesn't take any garbage from anyone, so if there are any of you who think that you are intimidating him with your threats of physical violence, we tell you that you are barking up the wrong tree, as you say, and if any of you think that you're going to intimidate him with threats of legal action, we say Greg has seen that all too. He has seen the inside of a jail cell many more times than one time, and so has his brother. They grew up in tough circumstances and have had it tough most of their lives. They did not pick and choose lifetimes of ease and comfort and wealth and power. No. They chose lifetimes that would challenge them, and challenge them they did. And for this they have come out much stronger beings than they went in, and that's what it's all about. And that's what we want you to remember whenever you find yourselves struggling and living through hardship. Many of you wished for just these things, just these experiences, for you felt that you would emerge a stronger and wiser being from it all, and you are. So many of you have grown so much and you can have no idea. The being you are today is head and shoulders, as you say, above the being that began this incarnation for you many decades ago in this lifetime. You are emerging a prouder, stronger, wiser, more courageous, experienced and knowledgeable being. Many of you wish to be sages and spiritual teachers and lecturers and leaders and commanders yourselves. And we say that all these things are very possible for you, and one of the things that has made these things possible for you is the challenges and hardships and struggles and tests of your will and your drive and determination and your fortitude and your stamina and your bravery and your courage in this lifetime. So we say to you, do not look at your life as one disaster after another or one challenge after another. Look at it as one golden opportunity after another, for this is what your life is. It is a long series of opportunities. These opportunities were designed for you and they were designed by you without assistance. We do not throw these obstacles in your way or pull the rug out beneath your feet, as you say. No. You have designed and created and implemented these obstacles, and you still do so today, for you see, many of you also have higher selves. It is not just Greg, our channel, who has a higher self. Many of you reading these words right now have a higher self too, because you are his or her vehicle. You are him or her, and they wish for you and they wish for themselves to get everything they can out of this lifetime, to reach every potential they have made available for themselves, and they are not going to squander this opportunity by taking it easy on you, for that is not why you have come here. So what they do is they see an opportunity and act. They take advantage of it by placing an obstacle in your way. Yes. This may seem cold-hearted and mean and even vicious to some of you, but we say to you, this is what you and your higher self, who are one by the way, not two beings. But for the purposes of our discussion we shall clarify by using two separate points of view, have agreed upon. Your higher self sees what you're going through, and does he or she lighten up on you and take the foot off the gas pedal, as you say? No, they pour it on and throw yet another obstacle in your path, for they see how strong you are growing through. Facing these obstacles and finding suitable solutions to clearing them from your path. So naturally, as your higher self sees your progression and sees how much you are strengthening and growing and maturing, he or she is going to continue to throw obstacles in your path, and that they do, day in and day out. So when your life is full of all these obstacles and they just keep coming and you look up to the skies and you shout, why, now you know. That is why you are here. That is what you wanted and that is what you will get. And you are going to be so glad you experienced all this once all this is over. There will be no looking back in regret, this we can assure you. You will be standing up on a mountain peak with arms raised over your head yelling to the top of your lungs, I did it, and I am a much stronger and wiser and courageous being than I ever was before. This is what we wish for you to remember today. that everything that you are experiencing today and you will experience tomorrow has been designed to strengthen you, to test you, to build upon what is already a very strong, wise, powerful and courageous being, for that is who you are in your essence. You are not a weak, frail and frightened mouse. No. If you were, you would not be here. You are something so much more. You have power, you have strength, you have many years of experience behind you, and we wish you to always remember that the next time a challenge comes your way, the challenge was custom designed just for you by you yourself. So there is no other person or organization to blame for these obstacles. These obstacles that were created and placed in your path by you yourself. See this and understand this the next time an obstacle comes into view, for we wish you to cherish this obstacle, for in a way you do, and we wish you to gain all it is you can by meeting this challenge head on and conquering it. This is something you've been doing repeatedly through each and every one of your long line of incarnations. Don't stop now. You're just a few hurdles remaining from the finish line. Don't you see this? Now is not the time to quit. Now is not the time to give up or slow your efforts in any way and say to yourself, I just cannot do this anymore and these challenges are too tough, so I give up now. We will not allow this. Your higher self will not allow this. And there will come a day, and it will be soon for many of you, where you will defeat the last and final object placed in your path. Think about that. The last object placed in your path before your ascension into the higher realms. Do you realize what a triumph this will be? Can you just feel it now? You're so close. Keep fighting. Keep pushing, because this day is almost at hand. We say to you to keep your eye on the prize, as you say, for it is so worth everything that you are going through today and everything you have gone through throughout the entire long list of your incarnations into the physical. You are strong. You are eternal. You are courageous. You are vastly intelligent, and you have gone so much further than so many of your brothers and sisters. You may say that you too are those who have gone on before so many others. Do you see how this works? It is not just we that have gone on before you, but you have gone on before so many others, and this is why we are all the same. We are just stepping into footprints that someone else has left before us. But these footprints are all synchronized, for we are all going through the same lessons, only catered a little bit to each individual and his or her personalities and what they felt was necessary to allow them to extract everything they can from the situation. But we say to you, for the most part, we all experience the same exact lessons, for there is not too many different designs, if you will, for your challenges and obstacles. They are categorized very neatly here in great books, if you will. We have them on computers, but we say to you it is just as if you are walking into a library and you can open up a book and there is a list of challenges that you and we and everyone else will be faced with. Do you see this is not just living on the cuff, as you say, but this is a very organized procedure where you select from these books the challenges that you wish to experience for yourselves. You then incarnate, and these challenges that you selected yourself begin to manifest before you. This is why it may seem at times that there is just one challenge after another in your lifetime, one obstacle after another, one problem, one disaster, for this is true. You are being very perceptive. There is a long line of these challenges, for that is how you plant it, and that is how we, with your higher selves in many cases, are implementing them for you. We just wish you to remember this the next time a challenge comes your way, and a challenge will come your way, for none of you, and that is none of you, are completely finished with all of your lessons in the third dimension. There is still some time left for many of you before ascension. So we say to you, keep your eyes focused on the road before you, for there will be a challenge coming your way. You can believe that, for we are those who have gone on before you, so we know what is up ahead for you in many cases. We are your friends and your family, and we would never think of steering you wrong. We are here to guide you. We are here to help you along your way, and this is what we do each and every day. We wish for you to trust us more, and we feel as the days go on that there will be many of you who suddenly find a way to trust us, for we are going to make our intentions very clear for you all to see very soon now as we will begin one of the projects that we have spoken of. We will not say which one it is, for we also like surprise, and we feel the impact of the initiation of this project will open many of your eyes and open many of your hearts to us and our organization, for we feel we will now prove to you, if this is what you needed, our worthiness to be trusted and our integrity. We sign off for now, but we say to you to look at us as your brothers and sisters. Do not look at us as something else, for we are not anything else but you and those of you who have walked a few steps ahead, and that's all. We wish you to see us as family, for indeed we are, and we are nothing else to you but your family. We are not your enemies, even though many of you believe these reptilian-looking beings, as you describe them, are your enemies. We say again, we don't know where that story originated. It is not any information that we have passed to you through our channels, so we say to you, how can it be that you possess this information if it did not come through our channels? If you believe that this erroneous information about some evil reptilian race has been written in your ancient books, we would like to know which ancient books these are, for there are no ancient books that we are aware of in your entire civilization that speak of any negative or hostile or evil reptilian race. And if you believe that we are incorrect here, then we ask you today to share with us where these books are and what the names of them are, because we are going to read them. Yes, we are actually going to come down in your world and pick up one of these books and bring it back with us, and we will study it, for we say to you, there are no records in your ancient texts of this imaginary reptilian race, for there is no reptilian race such as the one you describe in this entire universe. What we are saying to you is, there are not different reptilian races, and there may be one that is hostile or bent on destruction and the conquering of your planet. We say to you, there are beings that may resemble reptilians, but none of them are hostile and none of them have ever warred with your planet or have planned in any way to invade your planet or influence your planet in any way, except those that are here with us as members of our organization who are here to help you, to assist you. We wish you to know this. We wish you to understand this and believe us when we say this. We are not lying to you. We are sharing with you accurate information, and you can trust this information, for we understand clearly the history of this universe. The history of this universe is well understood by many of the civilizations throughout. It is all agreed upon and all can be backed up with verifiable facts, for as we have said, we have technologies that allow us to replay any event, and we have done this very many times while writing our own history books. Our history books are a bit more accurate than yours, as your history books were largely written by members of the Cabal or their paid minions who were given instructions to write fiction, to write lies and blasphemies. Yes. This is what your history books are, and we are going to paint a clearer picture for you in the days ahead of your true history, and we feel many of you will be very excited about this, for we feel many of you are what you call history buffs, and we have great surprises for you, for we are going to share with you stories and tales of civilizations that you have never before heard of. What do you think about that? Do you think that is exciting? We feel that many of you will enjoy this very much, and we will enjoy sharing this information with you. We will also take some of you on field trips, you could call them, where you will see these events happen right before your very eyes as if they were happening for the first time, for they will be, for you will actually be standing in that period of history that these events unfolded. What do you think about that? Do you find that an exciting adventure? Do you find that worth the price of admission, as you say? Well, this is one of the treats, as you call them, that we have for you, for many of you have earned these rides, and we will be very happy to take you back to your favorite moments of history and even some portions of your history that you today are currently unaware of, or you are just learning about, such as your Atlantis and Lemuria civilizations. Yes, we will take you back to Atlantis and Lemuria. What do you think about that? And wait until you see what they look like. We feel the visions of these modern civilizations will astound you, for they are nothing like you may be envisioning, and they are nothing like your civilizations today. They are something to behold. They are something very much else. We will leave you with the four today and say to you that there is so much of your history and your past and your universe that you yet to understand. And right now it is we that understand these things, and we just wish more of you could find the way to trust us, for we are doing our best to share with you what we know, and it is difficult if you are not going to trust us or have faith in us. You can see that, can't you? So we ask more of you to open your hearts to us and accept us, for we are your family, we are you in many cases, and we are your friends, and we are those that have walked on a few steps before you. We are your allies of the Galactic Federation of Light, as channeled through Greg Giles.